prophet.
He plays a lot of Doom. Well, for a while, he was like his, one of his more played heroes.
Yeah, a bit of Doom as well. I don't know if this is really the best Doom.
No, not necessarily.
I don't know. None of those heroes really sound amazing, right? But yeah, Doom's definitely possible. He has played a fair amount of Doom. Overall, games played, it's definitely Timbersaw leading there, and then I think it's Prophet and Doom pretty even.
I like the AA response to the Dazzle pick, so.
Radiant team
next game,
back.
KZ, get it sold. Support to go with the Ogre, and also something to deal with the Grave and the heals coming out of their secret side. Deter them from getting any further healing, fellas, and. Alright.
Game KZ, one more ban. Should be most likely banning Simba Hero here. I mean, I think we mentioned the main ones that Secret have pried their eyes on.
I think Prophet's still pretty good. Just being an annoying offlaner, you can kind of put in a dual lane with it. Well, the other thing is, like, you got Secret like their dual lanes. Elder Titan can solo zone out a Batrider to some extent. Not going to be, like, 100% successful, but can do it well enough. So Dazzle could go off lane with, like, a plus one and some kind of annoying, like, a Dazzle Axe, for example.
I mean, there's that slight chance. I think they've run Simba Puck once or twice, but it was not very successful.
Okay.
So, I'm still thinking it'll be for Mr. S4. He does play a Magnificent Puck. What else is there? There's any other offlaners out there?
10 seconds.
Anything
remaining
worth discussing? Clockwork can be good against Lycan, but I'm not really a secret hero, not really a good hero right now.
Not into the Clockwork myself.
10 seconds remaining.
There's more unusual picks, like there's Jakiro, which some teams really like.
Yeah. Undying Dazzle offlane. It's gonna be the Prophet. Okay.
Yeah, I was actually thinking of Undying myself as well.
I was just thinking, like, what are these weird heroes we've seen Ice play? I've seen him play Undying, I've seen him play Ricky in the offlane.
Secret just really like to have late game. They always want to have strong late game. If not, like, the most ridiculous, then definitely heroes that scale well. So
yeah, and they do it without picking, like, a super hard carry. Like, have a support go late game, and like Eldritch, even Dazzle does okay.
Yeah, they'll have like a skill pretty well at Slark, but they like to have heroes that get stuff done in the mid game and can go late. Rare exceptions would be like sometimes Kuroki will play a hard carry, but when they do that, they always have a strong supporting cast.
This is a greedy last pick Weaver though, giving them Weaver and Lycan together. Batrider, who's going to be the offlane, you can't really rely on him to create too much space because he needs space himself to get that Blink Dagger at an okay time.
They could rock this Prophet, though, if he's not careful.
Yeah.
Chilling Touch on the Weaver is just such an easy kill with the Ogre support. But if the Prophet plays it well, he can just chill, block some camps, scout out the runes, deny them, and we'll see. Going into the mid-game, X-Game KZ have very little teamfight control. Just the lasso, really.
Yeah, that's...
That is a big worry.
5 seconds remaining.
But if they can dominate these lanes... See if they can pull it off.
Yeah,
Team Secret. Not easy for Bat to dominate lanes.
Is this Team Secret's
Prepare
first game this season?
Battle.
I think so. Oh, no, they played one yesterday.
Oh, yeah, that's right, someone was asking about that VOD. So, Secret are 1-0. They played their first game yesterday, beating Europub.
Okay.
I don't know, they're Europub. That's what it looks like to me. Add a U in there and it's Europub.
Yeah. You are a pub.
Go back in game, there we go. Figure out my little overlays.
All right. Well, we can go ahead and introduce our teams here. I'll start with the former Next KZ boys, X Game KZ nowadays. Towards the offlane goes Equal as the Ancient Apparition support, at least for now. Mantis going to be on your Weaver. I think we're going to see a bit of a switch up here. Not sending the expected hero to the offlane. It's going to be the Weaver Ancient Apparition there. Mid will be your Lycan, which was not very unusual. We're used to seeing this. The Batman will get the double reign of protection, all the rage these days on the Batrider, and of course that is handled by Stallcat. Normally plays their like offlane initiator style hero. Reeves will be your secondary support, not to be confused with Dota Cinema Reeves on the Ogre Magi.
Well, on the Dire side, it is Team Oso Very Secret. We've got Big Daddy Notel playing the Elder Titan. Kuro going to be playing the Slark. We've got Puppy on the Dazzle, camping out this top room. S4 on the Puck, leaving the Simba playing his Nature's Prophet in the offlane. Top room going to be spawning any second now, and it looks like X Game will concede it.
Easy bounty rune. And Prophet Triant going to deny the invis here.
Yep.
Kapow!
So they put Batrider 1v1 against the Prophet, which is, I'd say, a pretty even matchup. There is a slight... The problem is Batriders can't really get that value point in Flame Break because of the mana cost, so if you ever get too many napalm stick attack charges and he goes on you, you just TP out, so...
Yeah.
I don't see Batrider winning this lane. I don't see him losing it. I see them kind of trading farms. Similar story mid.
He didn't go boots first, so there's also like zero kill potential here anyway.
Yeah.
You're not going to get the kill level one.
And Prophet with boots first is okay, because he can go for a fast phase boots, which helps him like kind of dominate the last hits. Well, I don't know, dominate, but at least help his last hitting there a lot.
Man, so they used the Chilling Touch really early top. I guess we're hoping for that quick double. Oh no, he's gone for Sakuchi anyway. So yeah, just wanted a quick auto attack there, but didn't end up getting it. So yeah, running the tri-lane. Don't underestimate Big Daddy in these tri-lanes on the Elder Titan. He always seems to do work. At the same time though, XGameKZ have Chilling Touch and Howl. So Secret likewise have to be very cautious here.
Yeah, the Howl bonus damage is saying that can catch him by surprise especially, I think, but
it does have a long cooldown, so I imagine S4 will kind of be keeping tabs on that if the team's not already aware and informing them if it could be ready.
Elder Titan's just gonna say, screw it, let's go mid and throw some nukes or something. He wants to...
Throw your snipe?
Yeah, I was just about to say, there's either go for the kill or go for the career, because his rotation towards mid has been scattered, though. There was a Radiant Observer Ward.
He might just get a first blood.
Stomp, set this one up, Puck gonna orb on through, and easy peasy.
They even saw that, like you said.
Yeah. Meanwhile, top lane being just played defensively by Team Secret, so that's fine for them. They actually send Slack bottom lane, so Kuro TP's out of there, wants to get the matchup against the Batrider, and well...
I mean, that's just a... That's just pretty inexcusable lapse in concentration. Maybe he didn't think that he would actually go for that play, but...
Yeah. Thought maybe he'd go for the bottle snipe, and he was just going to go for like the loop send around so that he couldn't snipe it.
Prophet TP? Oh, just a at the DD run. I was getting all excited, rustling my jimmies, but there's nothing happening.
Simba has that effect on people.
So they're going to rotate the Slark to the bottom lane, so the Kuroki 1v1 on a Slark versus Bat. This is the ideal matchup for Secret. Prophet can jungle. Mid lane, Puck should not die against an Ogre like unless he blows his orb offensively. Can phase shift dodge at least one of the occasional ignites that come in. And in the safe lane, Elder Titan with boots is not an easy takedown. So I think you're going to see Secret doing really well here overall. Kuroki might have a tough time since he didn't get a fast start in terms of farm, but they can catch him up later with some profit rotations, maybe on the Dazzle down bottom, and they're just going to get more off the map if XGameKZ don't make some adjustment.
Yeah, Prophet just can see in the jungle, and he can even start thinking about ganking after. He's probably going to go for a heal up fairly soon, and then maybe farm another camp or two before he starts thinking about rotations and finding some kills. Although, with that said, a lot of these heroes are kind of hard to gank. You've got Weaver with the Shikuchi, Batrider who can Firefly out of the Sprout, and mid lane Lycan, fairly tanky, but he's going to be the probably main focus of any early rotations that there are, as we've already seen.
Just going aggressive here on the Puppy, but can't really do too much.
A lot of lane switching happening.
Overall, this looks like Seeker getting way more experience, though. If you check the graph, it's already 1,000 experience, which is huge for the stage. And it's mostly because they're running a jungler right now. XGameKZ are getting something out of this offlane. Mantis is doing good work there, and their cores are slightly ahead in terms of CS, but ultimately, Ogre, Ancient Apparition, both very level-dependent supports, not getting a ton right now, and
Kuro's going for another little walkabout. Heading back top lane. He's like, I'm done with this bottom lane.
He's definitely the biggest loser on Seeker for this laning stage.
Yeah.
He'll probably go. I wouldn't be surprised if he goes for a catch-up Midas. Either that or just they'll look for a ton of kills with this Bat Blink. But Kurogi does love his economy builds.
I feel like the way like you've got the Puck on the Puck to create enough space for you that you can get away with going for like a fairly late Midas here.
Maybe we'll see that Puck Midas that Denny's been favoring. It's actually pretty good. I'm a big fan.
Okay.
Sometimes the just rushing the Dagon can be nice.
Yeah, I think some games it is quite good, but we'll see. Possible a kill attempt coming at the top lane. They've got protection for this one. The pounce alone is giving enough. They bait him in to use the Shikuchi and then get the kill on Weaver.
Oh, that just can't happen. He was getting free farm in the offlane, and now all that experience just thrown right back.
S4's got he's got the phase shift, but he needs an ult to get away from this Batrider. He's trying to juke and actually gets the bottle up. Stalcut gets juked by S4 so far. One more right click's gonna be needed. S4's got no phase shift. Ooh, barely gets that kill.
Got him.
S4 somehow like zigzagged out of the Firefly and almost survived.
That's a really big kill. He was the one hero that was just getting out of hand. The first hero to level 6 this game, now that springs right back the other way, and they'll help catch them up in this game. Really? Very nice kill. And also, he was going to have a super fast blink. He did spend some of his unreliable gold before going down. Probably all of it. Magic wand. He scroll snapped up, but still, that's an important kill.
Well, we'll see. Yeah, so we'll just TP straight back mid lane. Has some level 6. Used the Dream Claw. I think he actually went for a kill on the Lycan is how that kind of how he got in, caught out of position in the end there. But Lycan still alive after that previous kill on him, so...
Yeah, that is something XGameKZ could do, is they can rotate the Lycan in the jungle and give the mid lane to another hero, but just a bit more dangerous when there's a Puck mid. Especially for, like, say, the Ancient Apparition. Very easy kill, solo kill for the Puck. You can have a Nature's Prophet plus one, and that's really all it takes.
Yeah, they'd love to get that, someone like an AA fast level 6, but both the Radiant supports are doing pretty well in XP. 4.5 on the Ogre, and AA was like level... just about to level 5, so...
Yeah, I think at least one of them was involved in that, and the other was pulling, so...
I think all in all, like, their XGameKZ will be pretty happy with this start. Like, it started off a bit rough for them, but they forced, like, Curate away so much time rotating between lanes that...
I mean, that one kill was a 1500 experience swing. Like, if you look at the graph, it's pretty much just that one kill. Because he was the most highly leveled in the game.
That is pretty huge. Imagine if someone's being super aggressive here. He's gonna almost bring down Crew. The Grave comes in last minute, needs to salve up. Time lapse, actually. He just hit level 6 not long ago, and Puppy, he's used Grave. One more Chikuchi. That heal bomb. He was not ready for that. That was just enough mana from the Dazzle to get that one off as well. Kuro also using his last bit of mana for the Dark Pack.
S4 on the move. He's going to try and snipe a Radiant Courier here. Say goodbye to your naked Greavel. One more auto attack or forward. Is he going to get that last kill?
He gets four and he gets four right clicks off it.
What a player. Has been
killed. I was like, if he doesn't get this in that third right click, he's not getting it, but he gets it anyways.
Whew. That was set up, I believe, by this Dire Observer Ward. So, nicely placed.
Dire's middle tower
nicely done, and that is going to mean a fast blink for your Puck, even with the earlier death.
Kuro top, he's playing with fire, and oh, wait for the heal! What a lane! This is Dazzle's pretty good against Weaver, apparently.
Yeah, apparently. That's ridiculous. It's a level 3 Shadow Wave. He's level 6.
That's a solo kill for Puppy, by the way. I think he got two levels out of that kill, because he got a solo kill on a level 7
Weaver. He's got too many skill points. He doesn't even know what to spend them on right now.
He's like, Weave, okay, I'll throw that. I've still got one left. What do I do? Poison Touch, Grave? I don't know.
Yeah, he's getting like the party sampler here. Yeah. You know, a little bit of column A, a little bit of column B.
Alright.
But at the same time, it's not all bad for XGameKZ. It's still a very even game. They're going to have their Batrider blink soon. They have the Sol Ring complete on Ogre. As you mentioned, Dyer's the supports for the Radiant Squad are attack. Doing well. Lycan, Vlad's coming online at a reasonable time. They already have Ice Blast up, so
yeah,
I actually...
Really early.
It looks like Secret are making the bigger, attack. More exciting plays, but truthfully, this is a dead even game. Mid-game for XGameKZ is exceedingly strong. I'm a little bit worried about the Weaver becoming a liability, but despite the deaths, he's still got decent items and farm for the stage of the game, so... I would say not all aboard the Secret Hype train just yet. It still looks pretty good if they can get this jump on Kuroki.
No, can't get him. Need the Bat Blink there first, I think.
Bottom lane, on to Big Daddy. He got stunned up, chased down by Mantis. Nice pick off there, and then back to top, on to Puppy. It's right around the Rosie here.
Yeah.
He's not a kill.
He's poking and prodding, but he needs to get out of there before he gets hit by a
Do
pounds.
Not die when you're this close to your blink.
Yep.
That would be a disaster.
So, for X Game, they're keeping up with Secret right now. That kill at bottom lane, helping them out, and all they need now is to, just fall back, get back his blink in the jungle, I feel, although that's going to be a bit tricky, because he has had his camp warded off on the far left-hand side. But...
Was that... Who was it, the Puck? No.
Warriors of the Wolf!
I just moved from there, but I was thinking to move on it. And
play it. He could have been teleporting and using it.
I mean, he's into some ridiculous. I don't like this.
Curse going to Midas. I feel X Game will have a nice little window where they can try and punish the fact he's going to Midas by either trying to gank him a lot, trying to push some towers before he's ready to really fight. And imagine Curry is going to. I think it's fine to go for the Midas, but that's definitely something X Game KZ want to take advantage of.
Pearl just came that top lane. I'm not sure if he's expecting the smoke, but it is coming. Reeves and Stallcat. Oh, maybe they don't go top. Yeah, they want to go over the tree line here. We'll see Stallcat just mosey on in. Lasso at the ready. It's not easy to kill Sarkid up. He just presses Q. It ain't gonna happen. Is he gonna get it off? Now they show the Ancient Apparition. Why? not really sure what the plan there was.
Yeah.
Why do you TP in the ancient apparition? If you want to TP someone in, like, any other hero, it makes
Weaver or something, maybe, who can actually chase, but here comes S4.
Maybe they're trying to bait. Okay, well, the problem is that your initiator is the one baiting.
This is a big ice block. S4 gets healed up just before it hits, so otherwise it could have been the death of him. Now Ogre's going to be on the run, isn't it?
That was a very curious way to initiate the gang. It is creating space for what a fucker, but it's not worth feeding your Batrider. Like, he just got his Blink Dagger.
And Lycan popped his ulti in mid lane, not sure.
Yeah, he's trying to push with the additional base attack time, I guess.
So 2 minute is under attack. 2 minute cooldown though. And meanwhile, Secret suddenly respawned. T1 tower top, T1 tower mid. Radiance top tower. A lot of siege potential.
They removed the base attack time up, so he only has a crit chance, which doesn't work on towers, so. Yeah, I'm not really sure why you pulled there.
Some sense of security in the push here, mid lane.
The last, so they might be able to jump in. Who's he gonna go for? He tries to go in, but S4 was ready with the silence.
Player.
Oh my. That's tough.
S4 Dota for you.
He just does so much for the puck, but they will finally finish time. And maybe it's even a deny.
CS4.
But no coil. How much can he possibly do here with no coil?
He's trying to go for a deny. That's what he's trying to do here. And they're gonna lose the Lycan. That TP out ain't gonna work today, sonny boy.
I feel like XGameKZ are just pressing a bit too much right now.
Overcommitting,
like spending too many resources to take objectives.
You can see they just like, they feel like they have to do more. Like, they were doing fine when they were just playing things slow, but suddenly they're like, okay, we need to do more than our lineup actually can. They're kind of nervous, or just the fact they're versing Secret rather than the team they probably consider on like a similar level is making them just make mistakes they normally wouldn't make.
Yeah, it really does seem like a psychological thing, especially mid, like going for that tower that aggressively.
Yeah.
And he forced it into deny range, and then he stuck around.
And he didn't have his ulti from, like, if he had his held his ulti for that, then maybe it works, but... Well, now we look towards Secret pulling away a little bit, at least. 2,000 gold lead around, similar with the XP, so it's still fairly close. By no means an X game getting completely destroyed here or anything. They still have a really weak mid-game teamfight, it's the big concern. Like, your Batrider with a Blink, like, he can try and lead the ganks, but the actual follow-up damage is mostly just going to come from an ice block.
Coil as well as the silence, the orb is going to connect Mantle, so does manage to time-lapse.
Barely.
Now he wants to turn on Big Daddy, but the annoying thing about the Elder Titan, he's just way too tanky once he gets Trax. He just can't kill him. Tower is under attack. 8 armor, 910 health, and fast once he's got the Astral Spear at move speed. We will see a smoke rotation from XGameKZ, but it just seems like every one of their ganks is just like a bit too obvious somehow. You know, like the lane's really pushed in. This is when Slark will go to the jungle, and they're baiting someone who's like at the tier 2.
And this is smoke gank number 2 with this Blink Dagger. They're yet to find a kill for Bat with this Blink, which is worrisome if you're XGame.
Go back to that earlier gank and think, like, what if they just gone in right away and not TP'd the Ancient Apparition to scare off the Slark. They could have thrown the Ice Blast, Blink Lasso as the Ice Blast is arriving. It is tough against Slark because you just have to press that one button, but you gotta give it a shot at some point, or go for somebody else if you're not going to.
Secret gonna use this little space to sneak them into Roshan, but it's top lane. Kuro getting ganked out on the Slark. Could try and Shadow Dance, but it's too late.
It's creative. It's well worth it for Secret. Slark here. He's got a Midas already picking in, and they're continuing. They're also denying this Roche to Lycan, which is a pretty big deal.
I think it's okay for X game though. It's always that Dire thing where it's like they're gonna get Roshan at some point. So as long as you trade for Roshan, they traded Roshan for a T1 and a Slark. So it's not like their opponents took Roshan and they would.
I wouldn't say it's like a guaranteed Roche for Secret though. X game have the Lycan. They can always scout the Roche with that. And they can take it very
It's
quickly.
Just like that Dire side advantage though, like you... It's just so hard to know when they're actually going into the pit, like they smoke in like that.
You can always just scout it with Wolves.
Yeah,
and Ice Blast.
Wolves
and Batrider.
These things expire, like you don't always just have them around the pit, I feel.
It just really close. Yeah, I mean it's not like you have 100% chance to block it, but
yeah.
It's also not like a gimme Roche.
That's true.
The other game, I would definitely agree with you, is a gimme Roche, Dire side like him.
If you're checking Roshan like every 36 minutes, like you get outfarmed, it's like a really bad use of your resources in some ways, so.
Well, you don't want to commit all of them. Just throw a wolf in there occasionally. Yeah. Throw an ice blast every minute or two. Either way, Secret do get a Roche. They give up their Slark's life. He's still farming reasonably well here, though, just behind the enemy Weaver, despite that death. And now they're going to get the tower as well, so it looks like they'll get the effectively 1-for-1 tower and a freebie Roche in exchange for just the Slark death. Radiant's now really be gonna be a good turn. So look for Mantis here. Bleak Silent just gets blown up with the spirit.
The burst
what
is
a
real.
Quick kill.
Yeah.
And there's your double Midas. The Puck Midas online.
Yep.
Escalor's been watching those Dendi replays. He likes what he sees and he wants a piece of the pie.
Let's secure that late game. It's good. You get the Blink Dagger and then you can like, control the tempo a little bit, get a few ganks, and then you just go back for the let's secure the late game Midas right around 15 to 20 minutes in.
Yeah. I really like them. Not every game. I think there's some game, like if you're up against the Skyrath, you might need the Yule Scepter just to deal with the attack. Silence, but this is a game where they don't have many easy tools to deal with the Puck.
It feels like they're good when you're ahead. If you're playing from like really far behind, it's maybe not the best idea.
Yeah, I think that's a good way to put it.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Well, Secret starting to pull ahead here a bit in terms of gold now. Up by about 4,000 gold, 4,000 experience. What do you do if you're XCMKZ? We've said they don't really have the best team fight lineup. They're a good Roche taking lineup, but they can't take Roche because Secret have already taken that away from them. They don't have the Midas advantage.
Get this bat rider. Get this bat rider full stuff and just try find a couple pickoffs. Like these smoke ganks with bat rider. It doesn't have to be a smoke gank, but combine the lasso ganks with ice blast and just find kills on Slark ideally a few times more and just keep it up. Like right now, they've got this heavy carry lamp that needs farm and needs items.
Bat needs to buy that for us. There you go.
Yep.
I was also gonna say I think it would be nice for XKMKZ to try and grab a gem for the bat, even though it's a bit risky. Just because I feel like Secret are really outmap controlling them now. They've got the Slark pushing in top, the Puppies pushing in one lane, the Prophet's constantly on the scout.
They've got a gem of their own in this board too.
Yeah, I was gonna say that XKMKZ should get one, but yeah, like you point out, Secret already have one first. And this is gonna be very annoying for the Weaver. No BKB yet. If he ever gets, I mean, he's kind of forced to go with this BKB. Oh, they might find Kuroki here with a Sniperino Ice Blast. Boom! Got him. Great observer to set that one up.
Nice play. And now people are going to get caught up. This is how you get back in the game. Nice Slark, find the Prophet. That's two
goals.
Two core heroes in a row brought down. Turtle Secret will get a T2 Tau, but for X game, like,
that's
you take what you can get.
Value. They got two cores there, and that is...
They may be defending too. I think Secret will be a bit cautious about committing full
ignites. No lats, so no.
Yeah.
They can ice blast to slow this down.
Just throw some ignites here. Radiant's maybe Puck will try and engage, but
sacrifice yourself.
Come on, Reeves, throw the ignites, man.
Well, they got vision on Stalkat. They're gonna. Oh no, they can't go on that.
No and Lycan's kind of pushing top lane, although Heroes respawning will be the ones defending now.
He is keeping up in farm really nicely. What a fuck has been spamming his ult just to neutral a bit faster. Used it to clear out a big ancient stack earlier, and it kind of reminds me of using the Razor ult just to farm. Lycan ult has a pretty significant cooldown at level 2, but it's not. It's like a juice ult. You know, you can throw it out and scout here or there, and it's okay. Similarly, you can use this to farm here and there, and it's okay.
Yeah, especially once you get like that level 2 and level 3 ulti, it gets much shorter cooldown. He doesn't have much interest in fighting right now.
He really can't, unless he gets BKB. I don't think he can fight this game.
There's so much good control for him. The Pounce, the Coil, and Elder Titan.
Like,
yeah.
The Heal Bomb, and just you're not killing anyone before the Grave comes out.
Yep.
Frustrated.
He's almost good as Necrobook 3, so we'll see that come online, and he's applying a lot of pressure to all these lanes with as a result of this, but...
And they really want to shut him down here, but this Observer Ward is such a value ward. Secret even
Dire's
saw Kuroki get killed there. Oh, they're also looking to go on bottom, maybe? Nope. Never mind.
Puck will fight. I guess he wasn't in range for his jump.
Dude, Astro Simba.
Got him. Maybe the Grave coming in. Triple TP from Secret. They want to try and help him out. Ice Blast didn't actually catch the Nature's Prophet, it looks like. And
man, he's playing fire here, man. Secret just does so much work. He does manage to snipe your Dazzle behind the tower. And this is without the Lycan, so I really like this for X-Game, actually. Yeah. It's a slightly favorable trade for Secret in terms of which heroes die, but
there's a triple TP, so they kind of... Yeah. Who actually... Do any of these heroes have TPs to go top?
They have the Prophet, but yeah, Simba can stop this on his own.
He's...
Big Bad Wolf's coming to town. Not a Necro 3, unfortunately, no.
There's a glyph available, Sid, tower.
Reeves, what you doing, my friend?
Body blocks
he's
are
baiting! He's baiting on the
Oh, and Mantis shows up at the perfect time. Kuro needs to get out of there.
And now they will take the tower for absolutely free. The paints come out. Puppy's a little peeved, but what you gonna do?
Alright, X Gamer kind of just finding their footing all of a sudden, and
the Lycan effect.
Yeah. He's committing to this tower. He wants it. He's gonna potentially go for a TP out afterwards. He needs to be careful.
Here, the... Oh no, actually, that's that coil. He can just TP out if he doesn't die first. Oh my goodness.
That was so close. I thought it was going to TP a lot sooner, and then the puncher up, I'm like, uh-oh. And then, oh, no coil. Okay. He probably got the message from his team that there was no coil, like, after a few seconds, and he's like, oh crap, I need a TP. Is it too late? All right, luckily it's not.
And they're sending in another Ice Blast. This time with Glass already. This could be another big one. Let's see.
It'll give some vision here. Batrider was already fire flying, but yeah.
But this is where they excel. When they just start to like find pickoffs, then they get to set up better deep wards. Actually, the paint's already coming out. They know.
They don't last for long. If they could get like a kill before it gets the ward, it'd be great, but that one gets taken out immediately.
Yeah, actually, that gem is becoming a real pestilence.
It's paid for itself, that's for sure.
There's also a gem in the... There was a gem in the Radiant base. Now it's on the Courier. Equal bought one. Okay. So your Ancient Apparition did pick one up.
Okay. We'll see Batrider probably pick that up soon.
I wonder if they should be... What do you think? Should the Ogre or the Ancient Apparition be getting more farm priority?
They're about the same farm right now. So I guess AA's got 600 gold, but... I think
Oh, God, so no! Get that jump!
Okay, he picked up the gem. Elgato's just standing there. He's like, look, I'll take one for the team. I'll be a good bait here, and they're killing off the puck as well. Zelda time. This is looking that okay. But X game, Lycan though, unfortunately, the heal bomb comes through. He's got no Aegis.
Uh-oh,
Kuro's
all kinds of trouble here.
The Necro 3 is doing some serious work here. Batrider will go down in the end.
Oh, they're getting run over by X game. The Lycan effect is very, very strong as they wipe the floor, bring down 5, hang on to their gem. I believe they collect the other gem. Now, well, the double gem, balling out of control status for equal. This man has the cojones.
Hero of that team fight, Elgato. He initiated that team fight and faded Secret in.
Poor Elgato died in the cause of the service of the greater good, but this is getting a little out of control now. And the issue for Secret is if they don't have a Fat Slark, they can't really control the Lycan or the Weaver. Yeah. Because the Weaver's got BKB, and the Lycan's just getting too fat in general. He just stands there and fights you.
AA's gonna get a mech. I was about to say, I don't think AA's gonna go for the accept. I thought maybe a 4-star, but mech's good, and I think farm priority will be Ogre as he builds towards his accept, and AA's just gonna buy, like, the mech, a 4-star.
Yeah, one of them has
a Ghost Scepter, maybe, whatever you feel you need.
I just want to mention, Big Daddy had an amazing Earth Splitter that fight. Yeah. That had 5 heroes with the spirit there, and they still just got wrecked. That's gotta be a big concern. Now, they did not use all the puck nukes while that was happening, which probably would have wiped out X Game if they had comboed it, but...
And Lycan somehow stayed alive on, like, 50 HP for a long time during that fight.
Yeah, that's... And they have... He has no BKB. They have no heals aside from Lifesteal.
He has no BKB yet, and that's what's going to be really troublesome in this next fight.
Is he going for one?
I think he really should. Puck, as well as, like, Puck, Elder Titan. Like, this is... Yeah, this is a great BKB game.
Yeah, Puck did not go for that eggs, which... Oh, they're going in mid. Lasso at the ready. Nope, can't get around him.
Top tower.
Oh, can he? He's really diving. I think this is too far, honestly, Salt Guy. He's gonna jump in. But S4's there, ready with the door. Okay, no BKB yet. Your Batrider will drop again. He will the flame break, but he's just enough. But does it come at a greater cost? The Grease gets caught out in your Ogre. A bit of trouble, but the Lycan arrives. He's gonna go to work on Big Daddy. The stop comes through. Attack. Grave maybe a tiny bit premature as the Lycan just surges in, surges out. It is a 2-for-1 favor in Secret here. Equal will try for his TP. It's only a level 2 poison touch, no stun.
Yep.
Make his way out. So slight win there for Secret and Roche. Will it be up? Nope. Maximum duration Roche. The RNG gun's not with Secret for
them. And that's XAM probably thinking, oh crap, that was a bad fight and we're gonna lose Roshan, but they may still lose Roshan anyways. We'll see a Treant just camp itself in there for some time. And Lycan,
they lost one of their gems, right?
I think they left both at base. Yeah, they decide they've done enough dewarding, so
they've got two gems.
I think that was the right move too, because they don't necessarily need it for any Invis heroes, so from their point of view it was like, let's deward a little bit, now we can just play it safe. Although Shadowblade gets picked up for Slark. Shadowblade and Blade.
When they have two gems in a bat, I'm not really sure about that.
It could get like one kill by catching him by surprise, and
maybe they just need that one fight.
They haven't seen the Shadow Blade, but...
I mean, they do know that... They can see that Stalkhead's not carrying a gem now, but... What happens if he just happens to have a gem and just...
Yeah, you walk into it.
Smokes onto you.
I'm definitely not a big fan of the Pink Plus Shadow Blade. You get one or the other. It's like, this is your initiation item, and you don't normally want to go for both.
And he's also up against the Necro 3.
Yeah.
I mean, the phasing ability of Shadow Blade is okay against the Lycan Creep Army, but I don't think it's enough. Like, you already have Leap.
It's partly, I guess, that like the logic is like you can blink in, pounce, initiate, and then when everyone else shows up and you're in trouble, you Shadow Blade out of there. But it, like they know you're there, they're gonna have Gem or Necro 3, as you said. And they've put Gem. They just did some dewarding. Yeah, Gem's on
it
the.
It helps you rat. That's the other. I guess that's the main thing. Is it is a slightly better
Radiant's
rat item than like
is under
partial Scotty, but. I mean, once you complete a Scotty, I think even though you're a little bit less mobile, you just do a lot more. Uh-oh, that's Lark! Speaking of which, he's able to quickly blink out, but they're gonna chase him on through. The Flame Break comes through. Oh, just able to escape.
Too fast.
It did save him there a bit.
Where's that Boots of Travel, Mask of Madness, Batrider?
How about a good old-fashioned BKB? They're gonna jump in now onto Reeves. Kuroki going in biz. And he will now coil on the Reeves. That's a lot of Reeves. He'll ask Morgan. Yule's dodge that ancient original. Nicely played. Now trying to retreat out. Kuroki not so lucky. He'll get chewed through by the big bad wolf. Puppy's out fighting well. And now it's up to CBS4 or Puppy can survive. They're both driven out. He's done though. Can he go for a TP here? Nothing in the inventory. He's going to drop. For sure, you're tucked into the tree line by the TP, but it don't cool down for 20 seconds. How the hell is Puppy still alive? Okay, now he's dead. S4 also on the run.
It's a blink out, so he'll live.
Ice Blast coin down in 9, but there's no mana for it.
The counter push from Fly at top lane is probably going to get a T2 tower, but we may just see T2 for T2. Nope, Batrider says I'm coming.
Though. They have no Ice Blast mana, though.
Ooh, no Firefly as well, which is kind of annoying. He's going to go check the DP Flame Break. Does he lasso as well? No mana, actually. Yeah. Just come on, I couldn't get it
they
off.
They want a Roche, but... Oh god, S4, in position. This Roche is low. They're gonna go in with the stomp. Oh, they just ran S4!
The Desolator! Pick
and
up
they
from
BKB'd early. Nicely played by X-Game.
That was clutch. X-Game have stepped it up. Like, they had that kind of moment where they looked a bit panicky and just to be kind of crumbling to secret around the 10 to 15 minute mark, but they have stepped up their game over the last 5-10 minutes.
Have they ever. Man, these are some really nice plays for them. Ancient Apparitionals have all been on point. The ward gate has been fantastic. The item selections, I can't really see an item that I'm like, yeah. I don't know about that. They all are just exactly what they need, and Secret, just not quite the well-oiled machine they have been. I mean, hey, you know, they're not infallible.
Kuro's not had a very solid game, and that's where, like, you have one bad game and your opponents play, like, their top A game, which, as you said, X game, they're all itemizing great, they're just executing their draft well, like, that's where you get punished if you're not playing at your best. And Kuro, we haven't really seen it from his slot yet.
Yeah. You look at a lot of games with secret wins, and I would say they're most comfortable when they just have a time bomb carry. You know, something that, if you let it farm long enough, can just basically just steamroll its way to victory. Almost like did you play any StarCraft 2?
A lit.
The Colossus death ball push basically. Yeah. I kinda feel like that's how Secret like to run, not with like a death ball pushy lineup, but just with like, okay, we've got a god anti-mage, a super stacked Naga, and we just we have to just completely throw to lose the fight. Stark is not filling that
role. We just saw how fast Kuro got brought down to his third HP. That was like three right clicks. And
I wonder
out
if having this type of carry is just not in their comfort zone. Yeah. But it is one game, so.
He's just got no armor. This item build of his, he's got no way to fight.
On the puppy, the coil was used. That's going to stun Stalkhead, but he doesn't care.
For the
maybe he should care. That's nearly finishing him off. He's going to fly for the high ground. He's still holding the gem for the team as the Yules will end momentarily. They'll try to engage on the pin shift. Teach him how to blink out of here.
This is just happening up on the lane, and they're going to lose Puck in the process.
Uh-oh. I think you go high ground here, right?
I don't see why not. Lycan still has BKB Aegis, so... Stomp.
And there's still a tier 2 time, so they have some time here. And Slark will find Ace Emperor from the sideline. not sure what he was doing that far away from his team, but Mike picked off Micro. They need that. Mike's just busy. Might have overextended the welcome of it here. What a fuck, we're gonna BKB right before losing his agent service. But Sprout's there. Sprout is trying to finish him off and will bring down the lycanthrope. Lancey's coming back, but has no ulti for 15. Simba, however, will pay the ultimate price as he drops us for on the run. I think they got a retreat now with that blind.
You're not worth chasing it for. What am I talking about? They just insta-KO him with a Deathslayer, Weaver, and a Fire Blast. No buyback available, looks like Simba gonna blink himself out of his sprout. Traps the Lycan here!
Kuroki's starting to heat up though. He gets another kill in your Ogre Magi, leaps over the ravine.
Okay.
On the retreat out. Have a lasso.
Puppy can't brave.
Rampage gets the kill, but he pays with his life. Another kill for Kuro. That's three big ones in this fight as he continues to deliver. Looking for the fourth. The Necrobook summon now. Oh no, he's trapped. We hear them going down low. Not dead yet. They're going to focus these minions desperately. Bring them down fast. What an exchange, but the Ice Blast. The Ice Blast. Is it going to kill the mark?
Dire's middle barracks
are under
attack.
Oh, he's so fast when he's in, when he's got the extra mobility of Shadow Dance.
Very messy fight.
Also, I want to point out, guys, that entire time there was a wolf just poking away at this rain deck. Almost finished the job.
It's up against backdoor protection, and Notel just laughs at it.
What a loyal beast. That was a really good hold by Secret.
Yeah.
Let's see, did anyone buy back? They bought back on profit and puck, so it was expensive. I honestly didn't even notice the buyback.
That was chaotic, but in the end, it's...
Lycan almost has AC, though.
Yeah, I feel like you sure killed the top XTM for the Weaver, the Lycan, but paying the buybacks and taking that much damage at your base is probably... it's not worth it, and you're still in a really rough position if you're Team Secret. Weaver's really farmed, Lycan's really farmed.
That's gotta be a lane of Brax. Yeah.
Skadi's online now, so it's just like, that's the good news.
Kuro got really fat after that fight.
Yeah. The thing is, once he gets the Essence Shift charts, he's fine, because like, look at him now, he's got 17 armor. Before the Essence Shift charts, when he's fighting the lead, he had like 6 armor. So, him actually getting a few kills and getting that momentum is going to be what makes or breaks a fight. If he gets zoned out and doesn't start stacking up Essence Shift, he's screwed.
Yeah, now with the Skadi, he'll have a pretty high baseline of agility compared to what he would have had previously.
But
Kurier might get caught here. No, gonna play it safe. I think you want to walk that hero out, buy your Hyperstone, and then go meet your courier rather than just... he's gonna YOLO it.
Okay. Korean nearby, maybe.
You are up against Nature's Prophet.
Probably elsewhere.
Yeah, okay. Well, they didn't actually see that, but either way.
Yeah.
gotta take risks at some point. What a fucker. He wants to live life on the edge. They're gonna find a lasso here. Catch up, Big Daddy.
Yeah.
He's trying to be clever with his wards, and he'll be punished.
You got it tonight. As you were saying, you gotta take risks sometimes when you're behind like this. Taking a risk to get down like a nice observer ward deep in the enemy jungle, maybe. Worth the risk, but not paying off there for no-tail. So
reminds me of those old fluff and stuff, complexity. I don't know, it was liquid. It was the smoke, like personal smokes just to go drop wards. You remember that?
Yeah.
It was like just so boom bust. So, oh, courier snipe.
Is it a Radiant Courier again?
Carrying two TPs.
My gosh.
That's the worst part, it was carrying nothing.
That's the third courier kill this
courier
game.
Yeah. Imagine if they didn't have 3 courier snipes. I think XGMKZ's net worth lead would be like 5-6k.
Oh, bro. No lasso, luckily, for him, and he's gonna... Well,
he uses the Shadowblade first. He still has that ultimate reserve. The foil on 3. Nice hit on.
Just defensive, though. That's
S4, the God of Puck.
Still like a let's get the hell out of here kind of coil. Not a good sign for Team Secret. And hey, if the push wants to come now, you got a minute without a Dream Coil. I think ideally you'd want to go for a Roshan before you try to push high ground again, but it's still got a couple minutes away.
I love this by Puppy. Like, I know they can come kill me, but it's worth it to keep these lanes in.
Someone has to actually TP or B top to do so, which means one less hero pushing, which means, they're probably not pushing.
And I wonder if XCMKZ just feel they can just go in and just... Oh, BKB by Stalkash.
Yeah, he wants to talk. There's a lasso available. S4 was trying to be a bit too cute there. Gets punished.
It's not a buyback for a minute, but at the same time, Kuroki's in your base. Puppy's there to join him.
It's not a big pushing slack, though. He's very slowly chipping at this tower, so they can...
Lycan also dropping low.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
TP out in time.
Just barely.
Man.
Meanwhile, mid lane, Weaver wants Kuro. No, Kuro's actually going to come out of injured here. We'll leap himself to the high ground here. Lasso not available for a good 30 seconds, so Kuro's going to be just fine as he blinks himself away.
Roshan will respawn soon. Who do you... I feel like XGameKZ can somehow claim this. This should be at least one lane, quite probably two, and if they can get that, it's game.
Secret had a good 15-minute Roshan lineup when they had the fast medallion plus treants, but now their physical damage is lacking. Like, it's...
Yeah, no minus armor beyond that medallion, and Slark has gone for more tank and mobility items. Elder Titan is no right click. Puck is no right click.
So they had good early Roche lineup, but like they don't have it. They can't just win there and sneak it really fast now. They have to have lanes pushed out in the like just then when they had the lane pushed out top and forced TPs. Theoretically, they could have tried to go for Roshan, but it's still very high risk when you can't kill it quickly.
Yeah, I would agree.
But let's see what X Game try and do here. They at the same time them taking Roshan not easy against the Elder Titan, the Puck. A lot of scouting potential from a Nature's Prophet as well. So, see how
here's
things
your
pan
smoke
out.
By Secret from deep in their own territory, and they're sending out a scouter. Faroki moving on through. Get eyes on the Weaver now.
That's a top lane. He's on with the gem.
Oh, the Wolf was just hunting that little scouting wolf, but Kuroki ducks into the big camp. Won't be spotted. They might catch the Ogre. It's probably the best hero to give up besides the Ogre. They'll have to get more. Quick. Simple kill for Secret.
Gonna buy back and... No Roshan up for another minute or two, so the Ogre kill not really going to amount to too much here. It does allow them to... Well, there's no towers to push down the mid lane. I don't see them high ground right now. But they're going to try it. They're going to at least try force TPs back, it seems.
Yeah, they don't want this Lycan to get any kind of creep momentum towards the base. They'll do a bit of scouting and dewarding potentially on their way out. Also want to mention a third gem has entered the field. One still in the Radiant base, one... Of course, on that Batrider, and there's another one on the Puck. So.
Okay.
All the gems this game.
As if
Ice Blast gonna find Sim.
Oh, close. Yeah. And I feel like Secret, like, they draft these heroes you can go late game, but it's still a case of not having, like, a true late game carry in some ways. Like, you're up against Batrider pickoffs, you're up against a Lycan who is a good big late game carry, and Prophet's got a Hex, Mjolnir that's kind of getting there, Slack's kind of that semi-carry as well, so... They're gonna have to teamfight really well around the Elder Titan Puck if they want to come out on top.
Oh, they're looking for Kuroki bottom lane, he gets lassoed, he did not guard Titan, he just Shadow Blade first! Oh no, Kuroki! Get some eyes on him, he can leap over the cliff momentarily, he'll do so. Barely escapes.
Was Ice Blast on cooldown? Or?
No, he threw it in that.
Well, he didn't throw it like right
away.
Oh,
you're
saying
the timing of it.
He was really late on the Ice Blast. Maybe it was on cooldown, but.
Top lane onto Mantis. Uh oh. Almost got the ground strut on. That would have been a huge play. I was going to time lapse, heading to the south, and
the juice.
They're going to follow him here. S4
space created the bottom lane, by the way.
Uh oh. Well, I think it's still worth it. It's 2-2 for a Weaver. Especially when they're this close to the edge, and they're looking for more. Ogre caught out at the same time. Kuroki kind of fucking people on the bottom lane. He retreats out. A really chaotic sequence of events. Reeves dropping low. The Batrider is controlled and ignored. And will end up bringing down that Weaver bottom lane. Kuroki, or aimed at Barisha bottom lane to go with the Weaver. But Lycan's in your base. Now it becomes you better back the hell up. He's got a BKB transform. The big wolf form. He's going to BKB now. Go for the TP out. Earth Splitter is cooling down. No way to cancel that one. And
all right.
My oh my.
Force all the TPs back to defend the base.
Two lanes of Rex exposed for Secret now against the Lycan.
They got three kills out of like for nothing really. I mean tier 3 tower and I guess the tier 2 as well, which was already pretty low, but it just felt like so many of those kills were avoidable. That's where I feel that was bad for XGameKZ. I think they're still in an okay position, but those kills were just so unnecessary to give up. And now it's a Roshan on top of that. So.
And now Kuroki is dead even with the Lycan.
Yeah.
And if this goes much longer, Slark is going to win a match fight with anyone. Yeah. I mean, he might already, because if he gets the Aegis, he can just buy it. Probably the Abyssal.
Yeah, I imagine.
I don't think he needs...
I guess you could consider if you want to go defensive the Lincoln Sphere, but I think that's just too defensive. Get the Abyssal Blade, most likely. Sell some Ice. Picks up an Eagle Song, so he's going Butterfly. That's... Alright. Like, there's Weaver and Lycan, like two big single target right clickers, neither of which has an MKB. They're probably not expecting the Butterfly, they're probably more thinking, oh, he'll go Abyssal Blade, and they'll have to or I guess work back towards the MKB, which is fine for Weaver, a lot trickier for the Lycan, who would prefer not to have to go MKB.
It's a pretty good split pushing item with all that extra attack speed, and it still gives you decent damage. 60 damage, 60 attack speed, nothing to see that, sneeze at. Grookey will get aggressive here. Gonna rotate on through. Stalkat, very close to jumping that. He's got a jam, he's got a BKB, and he's gonna rumble on in! Yule Scepter will use my Big Daddy very quickly. See that? They will manage to take him down. Out of the picture. That's a lot of the damage gone here. What a fucker. Gonna get caught out as he tries to run through that agony puck dream while it breaks, and then the BKB, he's unable to get much accomplished. Still they push through this top lane. There is no Elder Titan buyback. That's a lot of their damage out of the picture. Simba is not split pushing bottom quickly enough. If XDMKZ want to, they can commit for
they need to commit to a single lane. They're like, let's get the T3 mid, let's get the T3 bottom, now let's go top. Like, who cares about these exposed reactive? Let's just go for another tier 3.
Oh, well, bottom lane. Maybe they just want to commit to the Simba kill. I don't see how. Oh, Big Beggar, 1 second. He's going to get the hex off now. The quick TP. Weaver can't do anything. Just a quarter of a second late on the hex ending there.
Yeah, that's another Weaver with an MKB that could look to cancel those TPs with a MKB proc, but
they only really have, I gotta say, Stalkat seems, it has just felt like he's everywhere in the mid game. Early on he was very quiet and wasn't getting much done with the blink, but
yeah,
every time they found a pickoff for it feels like the past 15 to 20 minutes he's been the reason why, setting it up.
Yeah, boots of travel definitely paying off for him, and he needs to do a lot, because it's still getting to a point where XGameKZ, that team fight is somewhat lacking. Like, the kills are coming from a Batrider Lasso. The Lycan gets kited around by Four Staffs, Ghost Scepters, Yule Scepters. There's all these annoying things for him to deal with, and it's
Kuroki, he sees a freebie here on Equal. He wants to go. They're probably waiting for that Prophet ult to splash through. It will. Quick commitment here from Yusar, because he leaps on in on the reason and says, uh-oh, I want to get the hell away.
Did he not have the pounce right away? He waited a long time before he pounced.
I guess wanted to go back down to below ground.
Alright.
Double damage!
Roshan, still in the hands of the Secret.
Wrapping around on top lane though. Kuroki looking for good. He's got a double damage rune.
Yeah.
They have that Earth Splitter to cancel a TP out, even through a BKB.
Gotta use it preemptively. They're actually gonna start with Hexia. And it looks like he's going to
pull on a bug. Even if he just straight TPs, I don't know if he takes it now. That Clark just making short work.
Close. He almost, it was like 0.1 seconds away, but yeah, that was
broiled wolf for dinner sound right about now.
This is a tough spot. XGameKZ find themselves in. They're the ones who are putting on all the pressure and been controlling the mid game, but suddenly it's like, okay, what now? We can't really find kills as easy as we'd like to. We can't really just five-man push into Elder Titan, Puck, and all these just good high ground defense.
They're gonna wrap towards mid now. The lanes are just out, like you mentioned. There's just nothing near this dire base. And they're gonna find a jump in now. Kuroki on the leaves at the bottom. And has no way to cancel TPs. Oh, almost gets the kill. Now the S4 coil. Will this be another $1 million one?
He's cool. Just catch Puppy for now and maybe at least a deterrent for the Secret side to keep going high ground then.
Oh no!
The timing. Sick mouse. Tisk tisk.
For those who are just waking up for the Europe session, we've had a lot of pauses today from the earlier SEA games, as well as one of the European games.
Yep. Well, we're back on schedule. We're doing okay here. Well, this game's going the distance, maybe.
Oh, it's definitely going the distance.
Two more games after this with Secret taking on Hellraisers, and then Hellraisers,
which is the old Compass Gaming.
Yep.
Really strong team.
And then Hellraisers take on Goomba.
All right, that'll be my first look at Goomba.
Yeah. So, plenty of Starlight of Europe action coming your way today here on the BTS Starlight of stream.
Yeah, thanks to those who are joining us. Hope you guys are enjoying the games.
Are you enjoying the games, LD?
I am enjoying the games. I am not enjoying the pauses.
Yeah, me neither. I've enjoyed all the games. That third SEA game I was a little skeptical about, but all the other games have been really nice. And I don't know what it was. That game just felt a little bit sloppy from both teams, Invasion and Insidious, but I really liked watching Mythtrust play. They were like, considering they were 0-3 in the group stage, and they just like crushed Team Malaysia. That was
It just—it's hard for me to call. I'm just so used to the old Myth Trust roster with like Abba and Lakel, SD, etc. I think I've got two of those faces. I see that coming out to Kuroki. A secret continue to push on through. They want this like in the buyback. Come defend your own door. But, Lasso, 5-4, big takedown if they can get it, but they have some great for these designs for ages, then they heal him again, he's finally on the droppy here, but well worth the cost if they bring back two more. Still no leg in buyback, he's held it, but at what cost? Kuroki and Puffy are both pursued out, Ice Blast coming on this, pow! Down he goes.
Alright, what more can we get here? TP's coming back in, there's like an ad respawn now, and it's for...
let's just farm these creeps,
Yeah? No problem. He's got ages. He's got pounds. It's Notel who needs to be careful. He's one with a gem, just as the Yule Scepter as far as defensive capabilities go. And straight down the mid lane is the call from Ogre.
Balls to the wall. Easy for Ogre to tell his team what to do when he's dead.
Yeah. He's like, oh, look, guys,
Listen, I'm an objective observer. You guys go on the suicide mission. I'll join you once I respawn. Yeah. I swear.
Sells his Ag Scepter, buys a boot to travel, and good to go.
Yeah, please don't sell your Ag Scepter. Unless you are really desperate for that TP.
Kuro playing with fire over here as the Batrider swoops on in looking for him, but not going to get the latch.
The problem is everyone has secrets.
They have buyback if they want to use it. 15 seconds though, and Rain Tracks goes down. Secret not willing to throw buybacks to defend that.
All that for a Rain Track. So maybe they can get the... Oh, that stomp. So dirty.
Yeah.
Such a long duration disable. 5 seconds.
That's the end of that push. I guess Ogre's drawing got them a range rax. Good on you, Ogre.
Oh, Roush can respawn in 2 seconds. Or up to 2 seconds. 2 minutes.
I was like, that did seem awfully fast, LD.
Approximately 2 seconds, guys. Yeah, it could be within the next 2 minutes, though. That could be for Secret. They generally still seem to get the lanes pushed out. The Prophet, Mjolnir, the General Slark split push seems to be paying off overall. They're going to look to make a move on this Weaver top, but he could turn out really poorly if they actually go on him. His backup's here. Kuroki going to get spotted out. Be careful. He's got cheese, bro. And he manages to get off his ultimate early just to try and confuse XDMKZ, who can jump on the Simba. That big Weaver.
He's ice blasted, though.
Uh-oh. He's going to shatter. He's gonna shatter.
Clink! Weaver is
down
just
he goes.
Going
That's four
ham.
Dead. It's gonna be five as Big Daddy gets shredded as well. It cost them nothing except for that previous Batrider buyback and, yeah, another Ogre death, but...
Whew, four heroes at buyback. That's the good news. So, you're not out if you're secret and... okay. Mouse! Yep. Problem, what a fucker. I don't know if they're saying, like, what the fuck, we have a problem, or...
He is a problem, or...
Yeah, look, we got a problem player over here. This feels like old EG, when they were, like, publicly calling out, like, teammates. Remember when it was the game where Arteezy was Drow, and PPD is all chatting, like, dude, why did I pick this guy Drow Ranger? He's, like, 0 and 10. Alright, they'll fix their mouse problem, so... I don't see them getting a Rax off of this because of all the buybacks. Like, four buybacks is more than enough to deter a push. It's... yeah, unlikely to happen. Weaver actually went for a crit. He doesn't go for the MKB against the Butterfly of the Slark, but... this is better damage against everyone else. It doesn't help him so much against the Slark, but when he's right-clicking Elder Titan Dazzle, and the Prophet there just melted so damn fast to the Weaver right-clicks.
Yeah, Weaver, just to echo what he said, is... I think, like, top three bumped... I can only think of one other hero whose buyback is better, and that's Spectre. Buyback time-lapse on Weaver is just amazing.
I don't know about amazing.
If he's farmed, it's ridiculous.
Well, the problem you run into is if, like, you time... Like, what if, like, when you buyback time-lapse... Like, if you died slowly, then you time-lapse and you're low HP again. It's very situational.
Well, yeah, sometimes there's a situation where you slowly wheedled your HP down, but generally Weaver is not that tanky, so he normally is at full HP, and then he's dead.
Yeah.
I think it's pretty unusual that he's, like, slowly losing, like, 20, or, like, 100.
There's still those cases where, like, you get down to, like, low HP, and then you escape, like, you're trying to juke them for, like, 20 seconds, and they finally kill you, and then, yeah, you're not gonna be able to buy back, but... I can see what you mean.
I don't know. Every game that I've seen a Fat Weaver who buys back late, I'd say like 3 or 4 professional games, it always ends with him just killing 3-4 heroes and winning the game. But you're definitely right. It's not automatically good. It's just generally it seems to work out. So we'll see. See if Mantis has the right timing or if he shows up with 100 HP. I do remember one really bad game for...
The Burning?
Was it Burning? Yeah, it was Burning. That was one really awful buyback game.
Yeah. There's been a few. I think we have like multiple BTS moments with Weaver time-lapse fails, with buyback time-lapse fails. One of them was Burning, where he like was at the bottom tier 3 tower on the Radiant side and pulled back.
I also remember Loda buying back and getting 4 kills when like his whole team had been wiped.
Yeah.
After losing his Aegis.
It's definitely a situation, but...
Who would you say is better?
What, Lodo Burning, or...?
No, for buybacks. Which hero?
I don't know. I mean, at this stage of the game, it's like less so at this... Like, your Boots of Travel, so you can get back in with like a Boots of Travel, for example. Like,
yeah, it's just not instant, though. Yeah. You don't always have creeps where you need them. If there's like a Roche fight, or if your wave's dead, or if they see you TP'ing and just kill the creep...
Another transformation.
That is also... What about Perilous Situation?
Nature's Prophet would be better, since he has actual teleport.
But he doesn't do anything.
Well, this Nature, I mean, saying like a character. Like a proper farm Nature's Prophet.
Yeah. If you're ahead enough, I guess. Well, let's see. We're gonna have a big rumble mid lane, potentially. Mantis dodged away from Stunt. They're spreading the map nicely. What a fucker working on the top lane. Coil was used, but one bug is just gonna casually stand his ground. They'll bring in Big Daddy as well. He is just gonna man fight it out. He could be popped, and meanwhile, Weaver in the bottom lane, bringing back melee racks. This could be Mega's potentially. What a fucker. Will drop here, but he's got the buyback if he needs it. The Weaver doing the work. He'll bring down the melee bottom. The melee mid still standing. They also brought down the range top. Can they kill off Mantis? Nope, no way to prevent it. So they have to like and buyback if they need it. I don't think they will.
Big play, like just Secret going for 3 lanes. Like they knew there would maybe have buybacks, but Secret can't defend all 3 lanes at once, and that's not good. Lycan, I think this is where you ideally want a Roshan, but Roshan's not respawning for another minute and a half.
Just flanking away.
The wolf that can.
Yeah, he's doing some chip damage.
Unfortunately, it's a melee rack, so it does heal. But 2 melee racks left standing, and
we've seen a lot of wolves that can in this game.
So, Secret are really in a pickle now. Like, they...
The main way XCMKZ can lose this is if they blow their buybacks and die back.
Yeah.
If they just slow roll it, it's going to be very difficult, though.
Batriders is on cooldown, and he's pretty important to these fights, the lasso in general. But...
Puppy mid lane, could be in trouble here. Ice Blast coming through, he's going to quickly 4-step out. Batman's on the hunt, I can blink. That's a death up.
Yeah.
Even faster.
Mid lane, meanwhile, Kuro goes in, takes out the ancient apparition, and there's still no Lycan alive. So.
But it buys time for the Lycan, I guess.
Yeah.
So, push this port. Can they get reads? Oh, they can. This is not so good. This is where you can blow your buyback and maybe just turn into dieback if you're not careful. Now, Mantis is trying to duke it out on the other side of the fight, going on to save up very hard and fast. But bring him down, the wolf has respawned. Mantis killing off another, but he might drop to Crow. He will as well. Oh no, the jinx is real. Tallcat now trying to TP out.
I think it's okay. They're trading lives at least. They're not just like. It's not. They're not killing the Slark, I guess, which is slightly problematic, but they're trading lives, stalling the game out. It's not terrible.
It's not terrible, but. The main thing is Secret are not pushing high ground.
Yeah, Secret can't, like, the Batrider's alive, so with just Batrider alive, if he blinks and lassos someone and Weaver, like, times his buybacks at the same time, that's a dead Slark and you lose the game, so you can't push with just these two heroes alive.
Shadow Blade from Kuroki. He's gem on the move.
Love to find a pickup.
What is the gem status right now? We still have one in bat. I guess they probably
should be like 3 to 4.
Two more in their well.
Yeah, that's. There's at least 3 gems flying around.
The Shadow Blade has been nice just to, I guess, force like one of the gem heroes to chase him in fights, and I don't know, just maybe they don't really want to be hunting the Slark, but they have to keep eyes on him. But I'm not sure it's really done that much from this game.
Yeah,
it should be the next item replaced. I think the Blake offers you a lot more at this point.
The Shadow Blade, I feel, just slowed down his overall item progression a little bit. I don't think it's by any means the reason they lost. Well, they haven't lost yet, but I don't think it's
you're
the place where they are.
X Game KZ, dude, if you keep this up.
My boy's X Game KZ got this.
wolf into the pit. Can we see a big Aegis snipe? There's no demo member. Oh, there we go. He had a half second there.
Didn't get in position.
I think was controlling
his neutrals.
These big creep waves at bottom lane, bringing the pain.
Man, how big would it have been if that wolf denied the Aegis and the cheese?
That would be a team secret.
I feel like if you're secret, you're just like, GG. We lost.
And
instead they've got a breath of fresh air.
They've held on to their buyback from the X game side for the most part, so that's the key thing here. Just Batrider without, so even if they somehow screw up and get wiped, it's not the end of the world for them. They'd rather not, but...
Yes, sorry. In the meantime, Puppy farming towards what could be a potential Hex, maybe a Shiva, so they are continuing to pile on items on a lot of these heroes.
I guess we're about to get jumped here. He's being scattered by the wolf. Weaver can't be the one to engage. They need the lasso, and it'd be an Aegis as well, so they don't want to invest too much. A lasso for an Aegis, maybe not worth it at this stage.
Depends if Seeker can go right back in and fight.
Shiva's completed for Puppy, so...
They're gonna smoke immediately, but Radiant Squad in a decent position here to potentially break it safely and get the hell out. Mantis walks right up that cliff, that's the Cliff of Doom already, what a fuck is transforming. He's gonna be kidding, they need the Puck Coil to control him or he's gonna just destroy them all. Hiroki caught out, almost dies for this immediate Earth Splitter from Doom. It looked like it hit everything, but it did absolutely nothing it seemed. X Game KZ just surge forward, they've lost their Slark, he has no buyback, he's down for 90 seconds with Mounting. That just might be game.
Yeah, and S4 gonna lose his Aegis and possibly die a second time here if he's not careful. Well, time looking for a stomp!
And they can't rat. The lanes are not pushed enough. Simba's gonna try, but it's too late. They're gonna at least Mega Creeps have not just thrown right
I
here.
Think that's GG. They lose the Puck, who does...
No buyback.
Not have buyback for a minute, and yeah, Slarkno as well, so two heroes dead. This is Mega Creeps, and as you said, GG more or less.
X Game KZ pulling the upset. Rares Dyer's will be lost this day. What were odds?
A lot of rares.
8-16. Oh, man.
Alright, suck at fan straights.
Secret fan straights down. Forehead. There we go.
Alright.
Easy rares. Easy rares. Easy key.
Mega Creeps, it is secret. Not yet willing to call this one, but I. If they knew all five of these heroes more or less had buyback, they would probably be GG right now. But
well, they're trying to hold on, but they got 30 long seconds without their much needed Slark. Because what a fuck up. And once again, they're trying to find their openings here for Big Daddy, but more and more Chomp is dead, buyback, probably gonna die again real quick. Is X Game KZ onto the throne? Onwards and upwards for this one. They'll take it out, and they will spoil Secret. Woo! Knacking down here. Starlighter season 10 second place.
Wow, that was quite a game. X Game KZ, they had a few bumps along the way, but that's a big upset to be getting against Team Secret.
Lycan Dota. That Lycan pick really paid off for them.
I think Weaver played amazing as well.
Weaver played amazing.
He was the one cleaning up and getting all, like, I mean, his score says all, 19-7 and 16.